So today I wanted to talk about a technique that I like to use to clean up ambient occlusion maps in Substance Painter in a non-destructive way. In a game production pipeline, it's pretty important to keep your working files friendly to making changes, doing iteration wherever possible. So keeping all of your mesh maps inside of Substance Painter is really ideal. It's much faster than exporting them to something like Photoshop to make changes, and then you update your mesh and you have to re-export it, update the changes again. It can be time consuming. So this is something I like to do to clean up ambient occlusion. So I am working on this bird mesh for a little scene that I'm doing, and I have some ambient occlusion errors along the necklace here, and I want to clean those up. I still want there to be some ambient occlusion there, but obviously I don't want these artifacts. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my texture set settings, and I'm going to add an ambient occlusion channel into my channels. I'm going to go into my viewport settings, and I'm going to change to the ambient occlusion. So there's two ambient occlusion channels in the viewport. There's the mesh maps, which is what I have baked, and then there's the, once I've added the channel, ambient occlusion channel, there is a single channel that shows the occlusion that I've painted. So what I'm going to do is add a fill layer. I'm going to turn on my ambient occlusion. So suddenly we see something is showing up in here. I'm going to select my AO texture, the mesh map that I've baked, and I'm going to add that into this channel here. And we'll change the layer view to ambient occlusion. You can kind of see, you can see it up here. So we'll just call this AO base. We're going to duplicate this. These are set to multiply by default, so they're additive and making things darker. I don't actually want that. I'm going to set this to normal, so it just totally covers the base AO underneath it. And what we're going to do is rename this to blur and add a filter. Going to add a blur, probably set the intensity to something like 2.5 or 3, maybe 2, that'll work. And add a black mask. Okay, so now we're back to where we started. You may ask yourself, what are we doing here? So what I like to do is go in here, I'll add a paint layer. We're gonna go into my UV view here real quick. And if I start painting on, gotta make sure my paint layer is selected. I can start painting in exactly where I want to kind of soften things out. And it's very, very easy to kind of make some adjustments to these meshes. Going to do the same thing to the straps because I don't want to have any artifacts there. And there we go. Things are softened up a lot. Something I would probably do here, and so this is the most basic form of this, is to just set up your base AO. This is basically so you can just see what you're working with, because otherwise it's just a texture. Or a checker. So I turn on the base AO as kind of an underlayer just to see what the original map looked like, and then I set up my AO above that. And if I wanted to, I could also do things like add a fill layer, turn off, I don't need the color, I'll just turn on AO. We'll set this to pure white, set a black mask, add a paint layer. In fact, I could even copy this, the layer from the blur, and put it in here. If we turn it to normal instead of multiply, I could add some transparency here just so that things are softened out a little bit more. And this is, the AO here is not as dark. So you could, well, yeah, Yeah, here we go. So you can kind of see. Soften things up, make it feel a little lighter. You can make whatever changes you want to your AO this way. One last thing that's important to do as well is to, if you change back to your material view, you can see that some of these AO errors are still showing up. So the way we fix that is we go into our texture settings tab and we change our ambient occlusion mixing for it defaults to multiply. We want to change that to replace. And that means that the AO that we have painted in our custom AO maps will override the mesh maps. So since we're using the mesh map as our base anyway, we don't need to multiply with it. We can just use, we already imported that base AO texture. We're using that underneath all of our custom stuff. So this is just, we're replacing it with our custom AO. So don't forget to do that. Otherwise, your fixes aren't going to show up. So the reason I like to do things this way is because if I have to make a change to the mesh, if I need to make a change to the high poly, need to rebake something, it's relatively common in a production environment. You realize you made an error in your UVs, you need to update things. All kinds of things can happen where you want to do a rebake. What is nice about this setup and way of doing things is that it's referencing your mesh map. It's referencing your ambient occlusion. So when I rebake, this texture here updates, and I don't actually have to change anything unless I'm changing part of the UVs or mesh right where I painted. I found that this is a really fast way of cleaning things up without doing a bunch of exporting shenanigans. So yeah, I hope that is helpful. Try this out on your next project. Drop me a follow and a like if you want to see more stuff like this. And if you have any tips for a substance painter that more people need to know about, please share it in the comments.